you?
Good, how are you?
Good. Sorry, I didn't know that you had to sign in and, like, request to join us.
Yeah.
I've never done Instagram Live before, but how's it going? How is your quarantine going?
Good. I wouldn't say, like, my life has changed quite as much as other people's just because of my job, so I think it's kept some, like, continuity. But, yeah, it's been good. How about you? How's teaching?
Things have definitely changed. Schools are potentially, Massachusetts hasn't canceled for the year yet, but we're like through mid-May, but I'm assuming we won't be going back. So I'm learning to do like virtual teaching and interaction with students, which isn't the easiest thing to do, but.
Oh yeah. Some of my friends are teachers and I give you guys so much credit.
Oh my gosh, that's how I feel about nurses. Like, you are in the front line of the chaos that we're seeing on the news. So I appreciate you guys. And I know that you have exciting news with your job, correct? Do you want to talk about that?
I start labor and delivery next week. So
that's really exciting. So what unit do you currently work on?
So I work on a med-surg unit, medical surgical. It's kind of the hot, he's kind of where everybody goes. We get a mix of everything, medical patients, surgery patients, just everything. So it's been a tough year because I was a new grad too. So I learned a lot. I'm super grateful for it. But now I'm going to the specialty I wanted to do. So I'm really excited.
That's amazing. I'm super excited for you. I saw the gifts that Travis sent you and I cracked up so hard with the, what was it?
I like the push one.
Yes, the push one. I'm like, this is perfect. I'm like, she might find humor in it. I've never had a child, so I don't know if, like, women who are currently giving birth will find humor in it. But
I'm going to wait to put them on until, like, I'm a little, like, have a couple months of experience, and then I'm going to start pulling them out.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Give them some time. So since your job hasn't changed much with the quarantine and the social distancing, how have you been staying active and still working out? Because I'm imagining that you are probably working more than you usually do.
Yeah, so I work 3 days a week, the 3 12-hour shifts. So that's stayed pretty constant, which is, I've been fortunate because I know other nurses in other states haven't been as lucky as I am here because we haven't been hit as bad here yet.
Okay.
I've actually been pretty impressed with how my hospitals handled it. So it's been as smooth as it can be.
That's good to hear.
But as far as staying constant with training, you know, my gym closed and I'm definitely more of a gym rat. So it's definitely changed my focus. So I've been definitely running a lot more, which is good because it's something I've been wanting to do for a long time, but I haven't quite committed to it. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of forced my hand where I've just been running a lot more. And I recently decided to try for a mile, like go for my mile PR.
Well, that's awesome.
So it's like it's given me, and I need to have goals. I'm just that kind of person, like having goals keeps me motivated. So I set a couple goals that I'm going to work towards the next couple months, and one of them has been the mile. So it's going to force me to run a lot more, a lot faster, but it's okay.
You might learn to love running. I know that's something that Mike always says. He's like, the more you do it, the more you'll love it. Will I? It looks like, I'm assuming Jim Ross is your dad.
Yeah.
He says, you're looking, and then a bunch of emojis, and then he put Sugar Plum Go. Oh, it's so sweet.
Yeah, he calls me Sugar Plum. I had to teach my parents how to watch. I told them I was going to be on a live thing yesterday. So I had to teach them how to go on Instagram Live, so.
That's the thing. Well, welcome. Perfect. So you're going to try to PR your mile. What is your current PR for a mile?
So my current PR is 6 minute mile, but I'm not there right now. I'm a lot slower now. I'd say right now I'm like a 6:20, 6:30 on a good day. So I have a lot of work to do.
But I feel like you are such an endurance person that like running a mile is just like, I'm not going to run 1 mile. I'm going to run 70 plus miles. So I think that's cool that you're definitely stepping outside of your comfort zone and you're going to try something new and you're adapting because the gym is closed. And I know that you have a trainer, correct?
So I work with Dennis Welch in the endurance project. So he's been helping me with that goal. Because I told him, I was like, I need a goal. So just training for some race out in September or like November, it's not going to keep me motivated right now. So I was like, how about I do something now? And then, you know, being good at a mile will definitely translate into longer distances later on. So
absolutely.
Yeah, he's been really helpful though with programming through this, because it's hasn't been easy, and he's been adjusting workouts to fit what we have available, which has been really helpful.
That's awesome. And I'm assuming you're still running with your beloved tire.
I am. Yeah. It's been the only person I'm having, only thing I'm having contact with right now.
Oh my gosh, that's awful.
Yeah, but I love that tire, so it's okay. That's it's my friend.
Is it the same tire that was stolen and returned?
Yeah, yeah. They did steal, they stole everything else. They did not steal my tire, which I was grateful for.
I wonder why.
Yeah.
That's amazing. And then I know you recently bought a house, correct?
Yes. And that's been good for me, because it's been forcing me to actually do work on it. Like, so probably how you guys have been.
Yep. Yeah. Mike's like, okay, this weekend we're painting all the trim, and tomorrow we're going to do this. I'm like, oh, I love that we have a house to live in, but like the maintenance, just, it never stops.
Yeah. There's always something to be doing. And I feel like I constantly just have projects of like things I've started and then took a break on, because I got frustrated.
Absolutely.
So, but I finally put curtains up. It's taken me 6 months and I finally put curtains up.
Oh my gosh. Good for you. We have curtains in some rooms. We have one room. Our living room space has no furniture, no curtain. It's just kind of like, we'll get things and dump it in there, and then we'll be like, what should we do with this TV? Or what should we do with this bookshelf? So yeah.
That's how I had sheets up as curtains for literally 6 months, and I finally put regular curtains up. So,
so proud. So
I feel the pain.
So you bought the house 6 months ago, and then your boyfriend got deployed like shortly after.
Yeah, it was literally 2 days after. So yeah. We bought it, like we closed on October 17th and he left October 19th.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy. So
he has not lived in the house at all, but he's been buying stuff, because he's better at like setting up and decorating and things like that. He's better than I am. So he's been buying stuff. It's just, he has never lived in it, which is crazy. And he was supposed to come back in a week, but they got delayed. So he won't be.
Oh no.
Yeah, they have like a TBD date now. So it looks like it won't be till June. So
I'm so sorry. That stings.
That's
really rough, but hopefully June, like it kind of seems far away, but it's not that far away at the same time. So
Hopefully
June will be when he comes back. He's a doctor, right?
Yeah, he's a flight doctor. So he's attached to the flying squadron. So he's their doctor, but he also works in the clinic out there. So he kind of gets to do a lot of different things.
That's exciting for him.
Yeah. It's physical job. He just had his 42nd flight, and he's going to fly tomorrow too on Easter, which is cool.
Oh, that is
cool. Yeah.
Awesome. So I don't want to keep you too long, but what would you say, in your opinion, is the greatest sports movie of all time?
Oh, I was so hoping you'd bring this up. Miracle, hands down.
Absolutely.
Any excuse I can have to watch that movie, I will watch it. And I was so happy that
you
love it
too. I know, when you were like, what do you want to talk about? I'm like, well, I feel like we have very similar movie tastes, and Miracle is definitely like the number one movie. I was talking to Mike about it yesterday, and I'm like, oh, we should watch Miracle again. He's like, I don't think I've ever seen it. I'm like, no, you've sat down with me and watched it, and you said it was not that good. Right?
How do you not like Miracle?
I don't know. He's like not a good sports person, but I'm like, this is the best sports movie, like hands down of all time.
Yeah, so sports movies are like my go-to during this time. I'm kind of like cycling through my favorite sports movies.
Which other movies do you cycle through?
All the Rockies.
Okay.
And then the Creeds. I could watch both the Creeds just on repeat. I love those movies so much.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy. I don't think I've seen either Creed movie.
Okay, you need to watch the Creed movies.
Are they on Netflix or Hulu?
We bought them on Prime. So,
okay. I also have Amazon Prime. Obstacle Racing Media says, hey, homies. Hey, Matt.
Hey, Matt.
And then, Erin, what's on your race schedule for this year? I know we were supposed to see you at Fit Challenge, but I saw you ran a
marathon. So bummed.
I know. We were bummed when City Field and Fit were the same weekend. Yeah. And then City Field canceled, like, significantly earlier. So we were like, perfect. Like, I don't think Rob McQuay would cancel an event. And then that happened. And we were like, oh, guess we'll just do the virtual race.
Yeah. Did you guys do the virtual race?
No, we ended up not doing it.
Okay. I did like a 13-mile trail run.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So are you officially signed up for World's Toughest?
Yeah. So my goal this year, and is to try to do Spartan's 24-hour race and then World's Toughest Mudder.
Okay.
It's kind of like, they're like 7 weeks apart, so I feel like it's like just doable, but it's going to depend on how my job goes and if that's going to be feasible with that, because that's also going to be a pretty busy time being a labor delivery nurse in November.
Is that like the hot time?
Well, I just feel like with all, like, in my like logic, I feel like winter time is a time where that stuff happens. And then I also feel like all the Corona stuff, I feel like it's going to be a busy time. So it's going to depend on all of that, but I would like to try to do both.
I didn't think about that. So you'll be at the Killington 24-hour ultra.
That's what I want to try to do. Like, I would like to try, but it's so far off. It's hard to like plan for that, but I would like to try to do both. So that's when training starts again. That's probably what I'm going to be training for.
Okay, that's exciting. Mike and I will be there. So,
oh, you will?
We're not racing.
Okay.
We will be there. And then we're going up to the Ben and Jerry's factory with Chris Mendoza the following day. So you should come with us.
Yeah, Vermont is literally like Burlington, Vermont is my favorite city. And I used to go up there all the time.
Oh.
I love going to Ben and Jerry's factory. So I will definitely try to go.
Oh, amazing. I know, Mike, we're going to have to like rent a car because where are all these people going to go? We can't trust after 24 hours of racing that people can drive themselves.
Yeah, hopefully Travis is going to be able to go. And then like Shannon should, I would assume, would come. So.
Oh, that's awesome. I didn't even think about, is Shannon going to race? Do you know?
I don't know. I haven't talked to her about it. She likes the tough mudder stuff more. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if she'd want to do that. But I think she's signed up for World's Toughest Mudder. So.
Oh, that's awesome. So
no matter what, I'm going to go to World's Toughest Mudder. So.
Mm-hmm. I know. Mike hasn't signed up for pitting or racing yet. And I'm like, I feel like we have to go and do something.
Yeah.
So we'll definitely be at least pitting. But I'm like, I feel like once we like start prepping and like getting closer to the date, he'll like impulsively sign up. I don't know if that's something you would do, but you could definitely always sign up later.
And then
did I cut out?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. I was just saying that like a lot of people, I feel like, say they're going to pit. And then as the date gets closer, they're like, oh, you know what? I'll just sign up and run World's Toughest Mudder.
Yeah, exactly.
Kyle.
I don't want to commit.
Mike, CEO Kyle wants to know why you're not signed up for World's Toughest. Putting you on blast. Oh, Will Hicks says
that. You're both on blast.
I know.
You should both race.
So, I'll definitely be pitting.
So I signed up for Toughest Chicago and training.
I signed up for that too.
Oh, awesome. So we'll see you in Chicago. That's exciting. But I keep joking. I'm like, if I get contender status, which I won't do, I'm like, then I'll sign up for Worlds.
Hi, Mike.
How's it going? I miss you.
Yeah, I miss you guys too.
I told Erin I'm like miracle.
I'm just not a sports guy.
That's just a great movie. I don't have to like sports like that. But I don't even know hockey and I love that movie.
Yeah, I'll give it another chance.
You should be a fan.
Skating all over my
That's your homework. That's your Corona homework from me.
Yes.
I'll give it.
Perfect. Well, Erin, do you have any sponsors you'd like to plug?
No, I don't have any sponsors, but it was really nice to talk with you guys. I miss your faces.
You too.
Miss seeing you guys.
When Will was like, who can you reach out to? I'm like, oh, Erin, like, for sure. So
thank you. That made me so happy. I was like, I can't wait to talk to you.
Oh, Carlo says, you know who else will be on Chicago?
Are you Carlo?
Carlo, are you running Chicago?
Wait for it.
Well, he says, you know who
else will be on Chicago. Anyone's going to be there.
Oh.
My question is, has Kyle McLaughlin figured out which one he's going to? I hope to see him.
Oh, yeah, Kyle, are you going?
Turn on you, but I will be in Worlds.
Kyle, are you going to Chicago or is it Midlands? Midland?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's not because they have, like, the
Carlo's going to be there.
So it'll be a little reunion.
Oh, my God, I'm so excited.
I'm so excited, too. I just hope it doesn't get canceled. But I feel like
positive energy. Don't say those things.
Now, August will be good. August.
That's my sister-in-law just said if my brother ever gonna compete.
Would he run a toughest or world's toughest?
What'd you say?
Would he run world's
toughest? No, so we had a bet. So if I got 75 miles last year, he said he'd do a tough mudder, and I did.
Okay.
So he has to do a tough mudder with me, and then he said I think he said if I do well again next year, he'll do a 12-hour race with me.
Oh, that's exciting.
So he has to do a tough mudder with me this year or next year. So.
Oh my gosh. That's a good bet. I feel like that's a good way to get somebody into the tough mudder world.
Yeah. I think he'd like it. He's competitive and he's getting into running and he has good upper body strength. So.
Oh, then I feel like he'll be better than I am.
Better off than I am.
Yeah.
And Kyle says, tough decision, ..
Yeah,
and
lots of pressure on him there.
I know, lots of pressure. And it has not been an easy year for Kyle, so we will give him some slack. Yeah. Okay, Erin. Well,
yeah, thank you
so much. It was so nice seeing you.
Yeah.
Good luck
Let's do a Zoom chat, just us next time.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's the rest of the world to see.
We'll do, like, a game night or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do that. I will message you.
Okay.
Perfect. Bye. Well, bye. Thank you. And thank you for everybody who jumped on and joined us in Quarantine Qorner.
Yay.
Bye.